Right, the Aussie Swag's boat loader for 2013. I forgot to get some footage of dropping the legs, and that's the first thing you've got to do, the stabilising legs to keep the camper trailer at level. You drop them down first by removing the two pins and then putting the pins back in. The next thing is you have to release the pins holding the hinge together. Well, it's not holding the hinge together, it's stopping the hinge opening up. And then releasing the catches on the other side, two of them. Once you've done that, the gas struts will pull the frame over, the top part of the frame only, and you can use that strap to control it. And then you've got a couple of catches on that side to push the frame together again on the smaller hinge, which allows you to open up the trailer as per normal. When you don't have a boat on. Without that secondary hinge, it's too heavy. The pressure in the gas struts is too strong for the boat loader to be swung out of the way. The secondary hinge allows you to open and close as per normal quite easily. And that's the purpose of it. Pushing it back over, you have to release those catches again. And you can't really reach high enough to grab the boat loader, so that's why we have the strap as well. Using the strap, you pull it back down and then re-catch it on the other side. The struts are not strong enough to make that hard to do. So that's how you use it without a boat. When you have a boat, it's a different story. It actually works the same, so I've changed there. Magical change. You just pull it over, the first struts work, and then the second ones come into play because the weight of the boat pulls it over. This is only a 50 odd kilogram boat, so it's not heavy enough for its own weight to pull it down to the ground, so James has to get inside. If you want to strap it, strap the boat loader down so it doesn't, so you can remove the boat without the boat loader flying back up, you use these chains. So when the boat loader is chained up, you can remove that boat without it. It'll just drop down and the boat loader itself will stay in place. So where the boat ends up staying without the chains really depends on the weight of the boat and what you've got in there. Now this new operation, we can't use it with the folding boat trailer in its mount because that adds another 70 odd kilograms to the whole thing. So if you've got an 80 kilogram boat, I mean, it's just a little bit too much weight for the mechanism to bear. So this is only for setups where you've got the boat only. So closing it back up, light boat, you can just use that strap to ease it down. There it is again. But you can also, I think James does it the other way here, where he gets around the back of it and allows it to come down. Again, depending on the weight of the boat, it tends to balance in the middle there. It's easier if you're taller. One more time. So it does a little, the second hinge does add a little bit of height to it, which makes it a bit different to open. Now there might be a situation where you just don't have space. Caravan sites are getting smaller. And in that case, if the boat's not too heavy, just over an overnighter and it's not too windy, you can latch it into place. So therefore it'll be sticking straight up in the air, allowing you to use the camper as normal, and if you haven't got space on the right hand side there.